Hello and welcome. Now in this video, we are going to use NotebookLM to add confidence to anything that we are producing in terms of our content. And where we should be uncertain and unconfident, we're going to be able to state it inside of that same content. Assuming that you are starting with content that you either wrote yourself or that you generated from ChatGPT, you're going to start by putting this into a format that you can import into NotebookLM. And our document is now inside of Google Drive. We have pasted into a Google Doc. We are going to import our source into our Google Doc. Our document has now been added to our notebook. We now need to add in a reliable source. This could be a book that you have read or a book that you know to be reliable that you have scanned into a PDF. We are going to upload a book that we have scanned into a PDF, and we now have everything we need to evaluate our content. NotebookLM is an AI with a closed universe on the documents that you upload and that you allow in NotebookLM. So we are now going to write in a specific prompt. The wording of the prompt is not as important as the function. You will not need specialized prompting if you understand the idea. What we want to know is, based only on the reliable source that we have chosen, where's the evidence strong or weak for what we have put forth in our content? And so we are going to ask NotebookLM a simple question. We're going to ask NotebookLM, based on the reliable source, how accurate is our content? We are now going to click Enter in NotebookLM. We'll need to return to NotebookLM with a second question. A better question to ask is, based solely on the source, is where the arguments in our content may be weak or inconclusive. We can then click Enter. What you will then have is you will then have the weaknesses in your content versus the authoritative source that you chose. You'll also be able to then go to the citations in that analysis by hovering over the number and then clicking on that number. You will then be able to look to see where your argument may be insufficient based on the authoritative source that you chose. Finally, one other statement that you may want to ask is, what is it that's in our document that we can't say for certain based on the authoritative source? And you want to be able to state that in your query. You then want to click Enter. And you're going to allow NotebookLM to go through that process. The process does take time. Now, this answer is not going to come instantaneously because a comparison and analysis does take time, even for an AI to do. You're going to notice that this takes a little longer than your common AI query. Now, if your goal is to understand what it is that you need to correct, you're going to take this document that you just did. You're then going to save it to a note. What you will then want to do with that note is you'll then want to take it, you'll then want to convert it to a source. What you can then do is to untick all of your sources. You can then take the analysis document or number of analysis documents, and you can then create what you want. The best thing to do is to go to the audio overview. You can either use a deep dive or a debate. In this case, we're going to use a deep dive. In this case, we want more rather than less. And what we're going to ask the AI to do in this case is to tell us what to do to improve our document. In this case, you may want to do this twice. However, what we're going to do is we're going to X out of here. We are going to select all the sources in this case, even though we're basing it primarily on our analysis. We will then go back to the audio overview. We will then go back to the deep dive. We will then write in our query. We'll then make the detailed long query. We will then click Generate. And we will then await our audio document's completion. And the audio generation is complete. And the reason that you would choose an audio is because of the interactive mode element. Now you can just play the audio all the way through once. You can click play and it will start playing automatically.
Welcome to The Deep Dive, the show where we take your stack of sources, we analyze all the crucial conflicts, and we try to give you the fastest route to, you know, that real granular knowledge. Mm-hmm. Today, we are tackling a universal enemy, really.
But you can benefit best by going into interactive mode, listening to the audio, and then asking questions where you have them or interrupting the AI to ask specific questions. You would then need to click play audio and then click join.
Welcome to the Deep Dive, the show where we take your stack of sources, we analyze all the crucial conflicts, and we try to give you the fastest route to, you know, that real granular knowledge. Today, we are tackling a universal enemy, really procrastination.
Oh, hey there. How can we help?
Before we get started, what's the most important difference between the procrastination document and then the authoritative source, Atomic Habits, that needs to be corrected immediately if I have limited time?
That is a phenomenal question.
Yeah, that cuts right to the chase.
If you have limited time, the single most important difference you need to correct immediately is this: the perceived prerequisite for action.
Okay, let's unpack this. The original document, the procrastination diagnosis, essentially demands that you find the highest leverage strategic move before you can start.
Exactly. It assumes you need the perfect map. You need to resolve the strategic ambiguities first course versus channel, or you need to achieve emotional safety before you move.
That sets the bar incredibly high. It means action is predicated on solving massive problems first.
So as you can see, one of the things that you can do is you can put the analysis into audio. You can then interact with that audio as you are determining how you're going to make changes inside of your document or your content. So what we have done is we have outlined some of the changes where we don't need to be confident in what we have written or produced, and where we can make corrections, and how we can correct them based on an authoritative source. Okay, so thanks, and I will see you in another video.